Hi guys. Welcome back to my channel. In the previous video we shared a rumor about the Korg PA5X which was quite shocking for arranger keyboard fans around the world. So this time I will explain something that emerged from my imagination and about my wish list for an arranger keyboard. I will not be angry if you say this is bullshit. Because every user of electronic devices, of course they have a wish list and each of their favorite items. And here I use the basic layout of the PA4x76, because I don't mind the body design. I prefer to prioritize the features and convenience of the playability. Okay, let's get straight to it. But remember, this is just a wish list. Please be wise about it. Number 1. LCD and UI. Main display is something that is very important in operating the keyboard. I hope this LCD is larger and slightly bezel-less with Super AMOLED technology. This will really help visuals for outdoor. And of course with a simple, elegant and futuristic UI. Number 2. Keyboard sets. I wish 6 voice keys on this keyboard set, because if only 4 voices, it's not enough to play the style. Number 3. Data entry. I really need this function to manage system settings and file management, because it is very easy to operate and speed up the work. And almost all digital devices already use this. Number 4. Motorized faders. Motorized faders are something that is commonly used in this era. I see a lot of digital mixers use it. And even a Behringer motor MIDI controller. Because it is more suitable for adjusting the value on each channel compared to analog faders. And with a level indicator LED as a visual volume of each channel. Number 5. Mini LCD. With the Yamaha Genos concept, I think this is very useful. Because it is elegant and does not interfere with the main display. It displays channel icons, volume, panpot, EFX, and others. Color LCD and of course with Super AMOLED technology. Number 6. Rotary knobs. The rotary knob is useful for quickly adjusting the EQ. Can be used to adjust sound editing. And it can also be multifunctional such as volume, octave, panpot and others. Number 7. Mute button. Mute buttons are very important for an arranger keyboard, because physical buttons will be faster than program UI. You won't waste time going into the mixer menu to mute a channel. Press and hold for solo mode. This is very cool. Number 8. Multipads. On some users, they need this feature. Because it makes the performance look cool. Because this is very much needed for digital music. And we recommend this multipad with velocity features. Number 9. Assignable knobs. This assignable knob is very important to me. And I can manage with various functions. For example, set MP3 volume, VDF cutoff, VDF resonance and many others. Number 10. Rotary pitch benders. It might be better to add a rotary pitch bender, to help some users who are still not familiar with Korg's joysticks. This is really amazing. Number 11. Joystick position. Joystick positions with ribbon controller swap positions. And I think it will be easier to use together. Number 12. Style variation and fill-ins. Traditional music in my country Indonesia, requires a lot of variety of styles, just 4 is not enough. Likewise with fill-ins. So I want 8 variations and 8 fill-ins, I think that's enough. Number 13. Style LED Indicator. Yamaha's LEDs are very important to me, because it is very helpful and the style component is easier to know that whether it is empty or not. And the description is: red equals now selected or now playing. Green equals available or can be used. LED off equals not available and you cannot press it. Number 14. Korg sequencer button. The Korg sequencer is also familiar now. Yamaha calls it the Korg loop, and it's very useful. So I think that these buttons are put separately and independently. No key combination needed to record and play. Number 15. Sound mode. This feature is very useful for a voice or sound. Sometimes we want physical buttons to activate mono, sustain, fixed velocity voices while performing. And even this is an old feature of Yamaha. Number 16. Front USB. I slightly moved this rear USB and near the LCD, just to fill in the free space. Number 17. Audio output. In some files, styles or MIDI, of course, will be different from each other. Output division will help the sound man to adjust the gain of each channel, and can even separate the kick and snare and others. I think this is also important. Number 18. Audio inputs. Although I don't really need this mic feature, but some people use it to sing at home or in the bedroom instantly. Is this really important? Number 19. Mouse pads. On the right side, there is a fairly large free space. I think make it a mouse pad and will be more useful for digital Audi workstation workers. Number 20. The keys. Hammer action is especially useful for flagship keyboards, because it is very unfair if the features are expensive but the keys are cheap. And of course the music performance will be better and look cool. And that brings us to the end. And I hope the price of the keyboard with the specifications I want is not close to 1 Bitcoin. Thank you so much for your time and attention. I hope what I have shared would be beneficial for all of us. And don't be offended by what I explain, because this is just my personal opinion. And also just my wish list. You watching my video is a great donation for me. Now I would be very interested to hear your comments. Would anyone like to say something?